Welcome back today. Well, I have had a frustrating morning. If you watched our last vlog, you would have seen me talk about how we had limited hot water. We don't have no hot water. We both got hot showers this morning. My hair is washed again, so that's good. But we've had a few more issues. Today is the internet. It's been going out for like the last couple days. So we're back with no internet. Luckily, I don't need the internet to drink my wine, and I don't need the internet to film a video. So I'm gonna do that. Release some frustration by filming a video. But if you want to know more, a little bit more about our issues we've been having here in France, I did a whole blog post talking about the good, the bad, the ugly, about living in France and kind of our weekend, last weekend? Yeah. Some more issues that we've been having. Yeah. Anyways, that's not what we're talking about today. I'm gonna do my March favorites today. So as always, I'm gonna do just 5 quick items. I have one bonus item just cause I didn't think it was quite good enough to make it into the 5, but I've been using it constantly, so I feel like I should share it. So it's 5, but kind of 6, 5.5. If I'm being really honest, my sweatpants and my sweatshirt are probably my most worn items that I've been reaching for in the month of March. I've been home a lot. We did travel a little bit in the month of March. We were in Rome and we've been in Paris quite a few days. For the most part, we have been home, which means I'm in my PJs a lot. I don't like to wear uncomfortable, tight clothes when I'm home. But I won't bore you with pajamas. I'll talk about some actual clothing items when I do go out. These are the items that I reach for. But first off, I'm gonna start with a planning item. I showed it in my last vlog. Actually, it's my agenda. Very boring. I didn't use it too much when I first got it, but in the last month I've definitely been getting more into it and watching Christopher Allen quite a lot, and he's big into planning and stuff. It definitely does help me organize my day. I'm the type of person that if I get up and I don't have like a list there of things to do, I tend to not get very much done. I'll just kind of watch Netflix, watch YouTube, and I'm like, oh, it's noon and I have done nothing. So if I have a list in front of me, then it gives me something to achieve and check off, and I'm that type of person, it feels really good to really actually physically check off a list of things to do. So this has been really helping me, but I also love the way this thing looks and feels. It was really cheap off Amazon. I want to say it was like €8 or something like that. It has a little pen holder on the outside, and then it's just like a textured leather on both sides, nothing to it. On the inside it just says 2018, but the paper itself is super thick, really, really nice quality thick paper, so you can use like any pen you want and it's not going to go through to the other side. The other thing I love is that it lays completely flat. It drives me nuts when you have an agenda that doesn't lay completely flat. It completely changes my handwriting, and I hate when I have really messy handwriting in here, although it is generally still pretty messy. But it is weekly form in the format of weekly, and then also at the beginning of each month it has a monthly view as well, which I really like, so I can see the whole month ahead. I've got all our visitors plotted out and I can write in where we're traveling, and definitely been loving this. It helps me keep my day organized now that my days are very, very unstructured, going from a job where I work 12-hour days, 10-hour days, and I had a set schedule for me. They told me when I needed to be there, to being able to do whatever the heck I want for my day. This is something that's really helped me keep my day together and keep productive. Okay, so the first clothing item is something you've probably seen if you follow my blog. It's my ASOS jeans, my super high-waisted ASOS jeans. Did I already talk about these? I hope I didn't. I think I just put them in a haul, pretty sure. But anyways, they're from ASOS, they're super high-waisted. They remind me a lot of like a Levi's denim. They even have like the leather patch on the back here. They're super high-waist, they have the old-fashioned button-up fly here. They kind of remind me of like an 80s mom jean, but slightly more modern. They're not quite as like mom jean on the butt. They have a little bit of distressing here, slightly tapered but not super tight at the ankle, which I really like, so they wear well with my Acne Studio Jensen boots and everything. I got mine in a US 4 and they did give out a little bit. I also ordered 2 sizes of this. My light's disappearing. I ordered it in 2 different sizes because I wasn't sure if I was going to be the 4 or the 6, I believe I ordered. And they came in 2 completely different colors. The other one was more of like an aged yellowy kind of color, and this one is definitely more of like a true blue jean. So I'm glad this one fit because I much prefer this color over the yellowish kind of tone, but if the other one had fit, I'd just order a couple more pairs and then choose which color I liked best. But yeah, I've been reaching for these a ton. Whenever I leave the house, these are pretty much the jeans I throw on. Anything high-waisted is just so much more comfortable than anything that sits like below anywhere near my belly button even. Like the higher the better in my mind. It's got to be all the way up to my bra basically. But yeah, they weren't too expensive. Off ASOS. Highly recommend those. I love them. So the next item is another clothing item, and I've worn it over and over and over again. I'm pretty sure I've accidentally worn it in two of my videos in the last month too. But yeah, basically the jeans and this shirt and then a sweater over top has been my go-to whenever I need to be presentable or looking like a real person. This is what I reach for. I love it. Normally I'm not into super cheesy sayings on my clothing. For some reason, this one I love. It just says love always wins. Again, it was from ASOS. It was really cheap. I believe it's out of stock now, but there's quite a few other ones that are of a similar like graphic tee kind of style that I really love that I'll link down below. I'm trying not to buy all of them because we're gonna have to move again at some point, and I don't need 50 t-shirts, but I really love this one. It's more of like a boxy cropped kind of fit, so it tucks nicely into the high waist jeans. Really square, oversized kind of shoulders, so nothing's tight, and it's very comfortable for wearing around the house. And I also really love the mix of this blush pink and the red. I used to hate that, like Valentine's Day, like red and pink mixing. I don't know, made me cringe, but now it seems like, I don't know, is it like so cheesy that it's cool again? I don't know what it is. There's something that I like about this combination. And then I actually, last week or the week before, I actually added a pink cardigan on top of this. So it was like matchy-matchy and red and pink all together. So it was a lot going on, but I really liked it. The next item's a beauty item. It's actually an eyeshadow palette by YSL. What's the color? It's called Ready to Wear. And it's just a small little eyeshadow palette. All neutrals, browns, has a little bit of an orangey color here. I was missing my Naked Heat palette, which I left at home. So this has a little bit of an effect of that. And then a really champagne-y color, a pink color that I'll probably never use. But the two brown colors here are what I use the most. And the reason I got this, I actually went on the hunt for a small little palette that I could take traveling. I wanted something cheap, not this, that I wouldn't really care if I broke it while we were traveling. Again, not this. Because I was taking my Naked Basics palette around with me, or no, not the Naked Basics, my Urban Decay Naked palette with me everywhere, which is quite large. And I was afraid I was gonna break it while we were traveling. I didn't find anything that I liked, but I ended up popping into another store on the way home and I found this and decided I really liked it. It's so pretty. I love the gold. The colors inside are perfect. I've used it a ton. And there's like hardly a dent. You can see there's a bit of a dent in this one now. That's what I'm wearing today. It's just like a neutral bronzy kind of color. Yeah, nice big mirror. I actually did take this. This is the only palette I took with me when we were in Rome. And I loved it. I was a little nervous I was going to break it because I was just getting ready in front of the small window that we had in our bedroom on that trip. But yeah, love it. Feels very luxurious. It was expensive, but I don't regret it. And the last item is a TV show. I don't know if I'm really late to the bandwagon on this one. I might be, as usual, but it popped up on Netflix and I was like, Ken, we have to watch this. We have to try this show. And it's called The Santa Clarita Diet. And it stars Drew Barrymore, which is the whole reason I clicked on it in the first place. I think she's so cute. I love her. And it also is about blood and guts. Basically, Drew Barrymore turns into like a zombie mom. And she needs human flesh to survive. So she starts killing people and her husband goes along with her to help her find her food. It sounds really disgusting as I'm saying it. And actually the first few episodes are super gory. So if you don't like blood, guts, like all those like squishy guts noises, Ken was like, when we were watching the first episode, he was like, oh my God, I don't think I can watch this. Like he was feeling like nauseous. But for me, I'm around blood and guts all the time at work while working in the operating room. So it was actually kind of right up my alley for that reason. Kind of felt like I was back at work a little bit, which was actually nice. But the show itself is actually quite funny. Quite funny. It's really funny. And it's Drew Barrymore. What's not to love? We went through the first two seasons like way too quickly. We just soared right through them. That's all we were watching for like a week straight every evening that Ken got home. And we cannot wait for the third season to come out. I'm wondering who she's gonna eat next. Okay, my last bonus item is super boring, but this is pretty much what's been on my lips all the month of March because it's been so cold and dry here. It is this little Nivea lip balm. There's absolutely nothing special about it. It has zero color, zero taste, zero flavor. There's no SPF in it or anything. It is the most boring lipstick balm I've ever had in my whole life, but it's been in my purse all month because it's just so much easier than having a real lipstick. I like wearing lipstick sometimes, but this feels better than lipstick or lip chap, you know, matte lipstick, regular lipstick, all the other options that I have here. Out of all of them, this is what I've been reaching for the most. And I also just kind of like a really neutral lip, like the most natural lip you can get, just a clear lip balm, just going with my own natural lip color. But it also keeps my lips really nice and hydrated because it's still, I mean, Ken says yesterday it really felt like spring and it definitely smelt like spring outside, but it's been pretty cold the month of March, so this has been keeping my lips from becoming Cressy. Just has a really nice smooth texture to it, and it really holds onto your lip well. It feels like it plumps my lips, but I know it doesn't. Yeah, just really nice and smooth and holds on for quite a while, which I really like. Okay, that is it. That is all I've got to share for this month. Those are the things that I've been reaching for the most, what I've been wearing the most, what's been on my eyelids the most. Get your fingers crossed for me that our internet is fixed tonight and that nothing else crazy goes on with this house. I keep joking with Ken that the only thing left to go really is the electricity, but life in France. I think I'll do a little update video at some point or include it in a vlog, how life has been going and these other little updates that I put on my blog and sometimes don't make it here to YouTube. So that is all for now. I hope you enjoyed it and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.